In this video, I am going to explain the importance of why I polish the setting underneath the diamonds and how that helps a diamond ring to sparkle so much more. So keep watching. Hi, this is Vanessa from Vanessa Nicole, where I create custom diamond rings for clients all over the world. And today I'm just finishing up this beautiful double halo diamond ring setting. It's absolutely stunning. And in this particular video, I want to explain why I'm about to polish underneath the center diamond so that this diamond sparkles so much more. Now, all the diamonds on this particular setting have already been set. So I'm going to explain what I did before I set them, and also what I'm about to do underneath the center diamond to really make sure that it maximizes the amount of sparkle for this whole diamond ring. So the first step is, when you're creating a diamond ring and you really want to maximize that sparkle, if you've watched any of my other videos, you'll know the importance of setting the diamonds incredibly close together. I want to make sure that I'm maximizing that sparkle and not leaving ugly gaps in between the diamonds. But I've already spoken a lot about that in other videos. So what I'm going to talk about here is, before I actually set the diamonds, what I do is I polish underneath the hole where I've created for those diamonds and also in between each one of those diamonds. So that way, anytime you angle it, it's always gonna look polished, because once you set those diamonds, you cannot polish underneath them. It's impossible by that point. So I wanna make sure that every single angle, whichever way you turn, is gonna be beautifully polished. You know, a good craftsman pays just as much attention to what's not seen as what is seen. And the reason I'm saying that is because when I polish underneath the diamonds, it's not something that you're gonna be seeing, but it helps with maximizing the amount of sparkle long-term when you're wearing it, because every ring is gonna look sparkly and shiny right out of the jeweler's case, especially under those fancy diamond lights that they have at the jewelry stores. However, one of the ways that I allow the longevity of that sparkle to last for my clients is by polishing underneath the diamonds. Because what that means for you is that the crud and the soap suds and the lotion that get caked up underneath those diamonds, which it always happens, so you can't avoid it. What happens there is if it's a very polished, smooth surface, all that lotion and whatnot, it doesn't have any teeth to grip onto. And so the benefit for you is that it just kind of smooths off, or it gets washed away quickly if you're rinsing it. Whereas if there's like the rough casting underneath those diamonds, which is what you'd most often see in mass manufactured jewelry, there's like this toothy, sandpapery surface under there. So all those soap suds and conditioners and lotions and skin cells that get up underneath, that is unavoidable, it's just always happening. It cakes and it has a toothy surface to really grab onto, and then it's really hard to get out. You always have to take it to a jewelry store, because they have the professional grade cleaners and the steamers there. And even then, it takes a really long time if it's been years since you've cleaned it. So that's one of the reasons why I really want to make sure to clean underneath the diamonds and really smooth out that surface beforehand. So like on this ring, it sparkles beautifully. I mean, I'll show you so you have some sense of proportion on the finger. Now, this is a 1.5 carat cushion in the center with a double halo setting. And this particular diamond is not set yet. I'm just about to set the center diamond on this. So the prongs are still sticking up high. I'm about to set them. But what I'm gonna make sure to do is that all the diamonds underneath them are incredibly polished and beautifully set. And they're gonna sparkle magnificently. And that's really what we want, right? And so underneath the center diamond, once I push those prongs over, everything under it, all up under the four bars under here, it's all perfectly polished, because I don't want any of the darkness from the crud that gets caked up under there. I don't want any of that to just sit and look really dark. I want it to just easily be rinsed away. And by having a smooth polished surface, that really helps with that. If you're looking to create your very own custom diamond ring, I would love to exceed your expectations. Simply reach out to the studio. And like I said, 70% of our clients are not local to San Diego, and all of our custom rings are made right here in our San Diego studio. And I would love to talk to you about what you're looking to create. And obviously, since you're watching this video, I know you're looking to create something exceptionally well made. So I'd love to help you do that. Feel free to reach out, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.